Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my UMass Dynasty Season 2. Carrying along here, we finally got a big win against UConn, and now we're hitting the recruiting trail. Number 2 quarterback prospect in all the land, Charles Smith. We're still on his big board at number 2, and we're not that far off. So we got to keep pressing. Can you imagine getting a 5-star quarterback in at UMass? Well, we've got to try to make it happen. Another 5-star candidate, number 3 athlete, Ryan Tucker, has us on his board at number 2 as well. Got to keep pressing hard right there, and that we do. Trying to overtake Penn State in the recruiting here, and Syracuse as well, that's right behind us. So hopefully we can do that. Number 3 on our board, Ronnie Houston. He's only a 4-star, but look at that. He's only 1 point overall less than the man above him that was a 5-star. So, and we're really doing well with him. Looks like we're going to overtake Temple with that, with a lot of recruiting points right there. That's just a quick look at recruiting, how it's going. We've got some other guys that we're going to have to try to fill in for base there, but I just wanted to get you the top 3 at least. So it's on to a game against Ohio. We won our first game last week against UConn, against rival UConn. It was a big win for UMass to get the first one of the year. Now we got to take on 1-4 Ohio, but it is a road game, as you see Ed Saintville getting ready here, and the rest of the defense for UMass hoping to have a good game. Coach Junk Johnson trying to fire up the troops. Speaking of getting fired up, the Ohio crowd is doing just that, and they want to see a victory here because they're 1-4 and they're starving for some wins here. So that is their motivation coming into this game. They've not performed as well as they would like, obviously. So we get the ball first, and Pagel's handing off to Jim Mitchell, who's going to only get 1 yard there. But we're going to try Mitchell again around the right side. No, they track that down from behind, only a gain of 2. So 3rd and 7, Pagel out of the shotgun, and he's going to completely misfire a wide open Quayshon Smith there, unfortunately. And it's a 3 and out. So to the Bobcats offense, Tyler Tettleton at quarterback. He's going to throw on 3rd and 5, and that's out of bounds. That's not going to connect. So UMass forces a punt as well. Both teams just kind of trying to get it going on offense here. So Pagel is going to roll, find some open space in front of him. He kind of dives down there, avoiding getting hit and fumbling, which is a good thing. And it's a 1st down for UMass. So on the 1st and 10 play, it's a draw play. Handing to Jim Mitchell, it'll get 5 yards. 2nd and 5, Pagel on a little mini roll there. He's going to hit Mark and Michelle for the 1st down. Jim Mitchell, a run here that's going to get him really close to a 1st down. 2nd and 1, why not finish it off? Mitchell again for the 1st down. Okay, we're getting something going here now. In Ohio territory, that's not good though. A loss of 3. 2nd and 13. Ohio's going to blitz a couple linebackers, and we've got the perfect play picked out. Screen pass, Jonathan Broadnax is going to get a 1st down. Great play to end the first quarter, and you'll see the replay here. As Kellen Pagel was cool with it, just waited to the right moment to just flick it off there to Jonathan Broadnax, who gets the 1st down with a little effort at the end there. So UMass is finally getting a drive put together. 2nd and 9, draw play again, Jim Mitchell. Pretty good yardage. Okay, 3rd and 4. 3rd and manageable here. Let's try to find Rob Blanchflower, except this gets knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Unfortunate, because Blanchflower would have been open for a 1st down. Instead, we settle for a field goal and a 3-0 lead. 10-play drive. Only going 48 yards, but took 4 minutes off the clock. So nice job by UMass possessing the football, keeping Ohio's offense off the field. And why do you want to do that? Well, because Tyler Tettleton is dangerous with his legs as much as his arm. Look at him take off. Will he get caught? Antoine Tharp finally drags him down inside the 10, but it's 1st and goal. Tettleton looking to throw. He could run. He's going to stay in the pocket. And it's a good thing, because his tight end flashes open. After abandoning his route, he comes back across the end zone, flashes open, and Tettleton finds him. Let's watch the play here from the tight end's perspective. He's going to go out, and nope, look at him cut back in here and improvising. Tettleton sees him, and he hits him. Wide open touchdown. Ohio retakes the lead now, 7-3. 3 minutes left before half. Going to try another screen pass, and it was well set up there. We had a host of blockers, but he was dragged down from behind before getting any yardage. So 2nd and 10 now. Pagel, 3-step drop. Going to throw. Blanchflower catches that one. He had an unaware linebacker whizzed right past his helmet there. Luckily, he didn't see it. So hand off to Jim Mitchell. Nice run there of 9 yards. Second and one. What could we do here? Well, we're going to run him again. And, oh, wow, it looks like if he just would have hit that a little harder, he had an edge right there. But he gets the first down nonetheless. So play action. Pagel. Nice one there. Mark and Michelle finds him, hits him. First down, UMass driving again. Just inside the 25-yard line. It's a draw to Jonathan Broadnax, and it's going to get them good yardage. Jim Mitchell has been dinged up on a play previous to this, and he's a high risk. We're not going to put him back in the ballgame right now. So we're going to Jonathan Broadnax, and fullback Coleman is going to get the first down. Now, I played this game during a live stream, and unfortunately, I had bad clock management here talking to people in the live stream, and I don't realize it's almost halftime. I finally find out with 3 seconds left, take the timeout. Luckily, I do get the 3 points, but I feel like I could have pressed a little bit better for a touchdown there had I paid attention more to the clock. Unfortunately, I didn't do that, but you know what? We'll take a 7-6 deficit into halftime. That's good. On the road, we're keeping it close. That's all we can really ask for. So you see Ohio with the ball to start the third quarter here, and they get a first down run. Third and three, hand off to Boykin, and he's going to get a first down as well. They're running option, and it's running pretty well. Third and 11, though. Tyler Tettleton. Oh, my goodness. Eddie Saintville, you forgot to cover that guy. He covered him, but then he just kind of, like, stopped. And that was a little curious because I didn't switch him to user control. He just kind of decided to give up on it. I'm a little disappointed in the effort there by my AI teammates. But okay, whatever. It's 14-6. Broadnax gets a kick. Oh, and he's... Oh, again, it's just one of those things where if he turns on the juice and just gets the right crease, he's gone. They do take him down. It was a nice return anyway. Second and six here. Broadnax showing off, man. He's going to earn more playing time in my book because he is much quicker than Jim Mitchell through the hole. I know some of you said Jim Mitchell should not have been put at halfback. My bad, whatever. Maybe we can switch him at the end of the season. We'll see. Play action. Bagel. Well, he looked like a bagel on that play. He throws it right to Kristoff, who unfortunately is not his teammate. Oh, and Kellen Bagel going 0 for whatever on that drive. Okay. I'll try to get his name right next time. Boykin dancing around, but he's not going to get first down yardage. Defense holds, and they're pretty proud of themselves as the third quarter has almost come to an end. As a matter of fact, it has. Fourth quarter, UMass with the ball. Let's try to get something going. Kellen Pagel. That one's not going to be good enough for first down. So third and six, what do you got? Oh, it looked like he had a wide open receiver, but that is a nice play to swat it away by the defense. Comes around him and swats it out. Nice play by our defense there to knock that potential pass down, or knock it out of his hands at least. So third and six, and Ohio needs to come up with a play, and they do. Oh my goodness. Wide receiver rocked, but he hangs onto the ball that time. First and 10, handing off to Boykin out of the shotgun. Oh no, that's a big time breakdown on defense. That's not gonna help the cause. Ohio goes into the end zone once again. And it's now 21-6. Well, pending the extra point here. You see him running right in there. It is now 21-6, and we are running out of time. They're going to blitz off the right side. Probably not a good idea. It leaves one-on-one Quayshon Smith. He burns his man for the long touchdown. Tells the crowd to be quiet. Well, they got a ways to go still to silence the crowd. But a nice play. You see Pagel recognizing the blitz. He knows that means he's got one-on-one on the outside. And Quayshon turns on the Jets there to get a little separation, make the catch, and get to the end zone. The biggest play of the day by far on offense for the Minutemen right there. Maybe a comeback is in order? Well, let's see. We got 3:35 left and 3 timeouts to figure this out. It all starts with stopping this Ohio offense, but Tyler Tettleton confuses the UMass defense again there, running option, and he keeps it himself. Doesn't run as far as the first one in the first half, but it is effective nonetheless. We get a stop there to force third and five. What do we do here? Well, inexplicably, Tyler Tettleton passes, first of all, and throws it out of bounds. Clock stops. They've got a punt. They saved us a timeout. So with 2 timeouts left, oh, that one over the middle had a chance, but it's knocked down. Good defensive play. Okay, second and 10. Pagel out of the shotgun. Quayshon Smith, it's a first. Oh, no, he dropped it. I know he got hit, but you need catches like this. He had his hands on it. You need to hang on to this when we're trying to get back down the field. That's going to force a third and 10 instead of first down. So Pagel out of the shotgun again. He's going to hit Blanchflower. He drops it too. Yes, I know he was hassled here. He probably doesn't get the first down, but he's set up fourth and short instead. Can't quite keep his grip on the ball. Look at him try so hard. And no, it just falls to the turf. Pagel a little frustrated. Fourth and 10 now. Got to make it happen. Where is he going to throw the ball? Over the middle, but nope. They expected that. They knock it down. And it's a turnover on downs. Really unfortunate because it's right down in our own end. Blankenship's going to get the handoff just enough for a first down. And we've got one timeout left. So Tattleton quickly throws to Roback. That's his second touchdown of the game for the tight end. And all of a sudden, some separation for Ohio. 28-13 now. It's pretty much desperation for Pagel, who's going to load up once again. That's in a double coverage knockdown. Yeah, can't really expect much there. Fourth and 10. Once again, got to have it. Instead, Pagel gets sacked. That's ball game, folks. Ohio just turns it on a little too much. Late going here. We had our chances, but it is not to be. So we lose a game again here, this one on the road to Ohio. 28-13 is your final. Tyler Tattleton, deservedly so, is your player of the game. He had a couple really big plays with his feet and throwing as well. So the UMass Minutemen now drop to 1-5. Ohio improves to 2-4. We're going to have to try to regroup, and next week it is a game against Miami of Ohio. Come on back for that. I believe they're 2-5, something in that neighborhood. We'll try to get a W. Come on back for more UMass football.